Hello everyone, welcome to the Kaleidoscope of Pageantry. I am Vagisha Mishra. If you're new to this channel, do not forget to subscribe. In my previous video, I shared my views on Miss Diva 2020 badge, wherein I picked Adline Castelino as my Miss Universe India winner, with Roshni Sharma, Aavriti Chaudhary, Lavanya Gunasekar and Rushali Yadav completing my top 5. While I'm extremely glad to express that my predicted winner could actually win the coveted title and I was able to predict 8 out of 10 contestants accurately in my final predictions, it does hurt me to say that Lavanya Gunasekar could not make the cut despite of having such an impressive profile. Moving ahead, today I will be discussing my views on Miss Diva 2020 Grand Finale, wherein I will also be sharing India's prospect at Miss Universe 2020 and Miss Supranational 2020. So let's begin. The format. The best part of Miss Diva pageant was its synchronization with the Miss Universe pageant. The contestants initially competed in the swimsuit round and the evening gown round, and thereafter were narrowed down to top 10 semi-finalists. The top 10 semi-finalists were subsequently asked to share their experiences and their words in the form of opening statements, as we see at the Miss Universe pageant, with the audience, based on which the top 5 finalists were decided. The top 5 finalists then competed in the common question and answer round leading to the crowning ceremony. The host. Malaika Arora Khan and Sachin Kumbar served as the host for Miss Diva 2020. What I really appreciate about Miss Diva 2020 finale was that the host did not include in any farcical, tasteless Bollywood elements in their commentary, but rather did justice to their work with utmost dignity, which is what I really appreciate. Coming to the jury panel. The jury panel of Miss Diva 2020 consisted of 3 beauty queens: the reigning Miss Supranational Antonia Borsent, Miss Supranational 2014 Asha Bhatt from India itself, and Miss Universe 2000 Lara Dutta, who is also the mentor of Miss Diva pageant. Apart from these beauty queens, we saw 3 fashion designers in the jury panel as well: Gavin Miguel, Shivan and Naresh, besides 2 prominent leading actors of Bollywood industry, Anil Kapoor and Aditya Roy Kapoor. While we were told that the pre-judging scores were also accumulated along with the final scores to pick the finalists to advance further, I was extremely glad to know that the majority of the jury panel already knew the nooks and corners of pageantry. Now coming to the most exciting part of the pageant, the swimsuit round. What I really loved about the swimsuit round was the stage, the choreography, the lights, everything was stunning and perfect. But what I did not appreciate in this particular round was the background music. I think the background music was quite 80s for me. However, the major standouts from the swimsuit round were Adline, Roshni, Aavriti and Neha, along with Anisha. While Adline looked extremely polished and gave fierce expressions throughout the swimsuit competitions, I was mesmerized by Aavriti's sexy profile and vivacious aura which she exhibited at the stage of Miss Diva. Meanwhile, Anisha turned out to be very spontaneous in this particular round, and I was blown away with the flamboyance and elegance which Neha exhibited on the stage of Miss Diva. The evening gown round. I didn't really like the music here as well. While the stage and the lighting seemed amazing as it was in the previous round, the music seemed to be too slow for a pageant, which was quite a turn off for me. The major standouts from this particular round were Adline and Aavriti. The top 10 announcement. Adline Castelino was the first contestant to be called in the top 10 finalist. As we have seen at Miss Universe pageant, usually the expected winner always makes the first cut in the first call, so that was already expected that Adline may walk home with the crown tonight. Later we had Anisha, Vaishnavi, Aavriti, Archana, Neha, Malashya, Arshina and Rushali joining in. In my final predictions, I had Shreya Punja and Lavanya Gunasekar in the place of Malashya Kashyap and Neha Jaiswal. However, while watching the finale, I observed that both Shreya and Lavanya were a little bit dull and low on energy as compared to Malashya and Neha. So I would call their placements completely justified in the finale. Coming to the eloquence, Adline speaks less but creates an everlasting impression. She not only sounds confident and unique but comes across as a highly convincing personality, which may give her an edge when she will be competing at the Miss Universe stage. Next, I have Anisha. Now, we had heard in the preliminary competition that Anisha speaks very well and she has been titled as the best speaker in a debate conducted at the Bombay High Court. So, I was expecting a lot more from Anisha in the final question and answer round. Now, she did speak well, but what I found in her speech was a rehearsed sort of vibe. When she was talking, she was not sounding as convincing as other contestants. So I think this was the major loophole in her speech. She needs to be more spontaneous and natural when she's speaking. I was completely mesmerized by Archana's words. She spoke very confidently and I really want to see her coming back while improving her styling. Neha Jaiswal, now she sounded extremely convincing, natural and vivacious. I loved her stage presence. Aavriti spoke well and she was extremely confident in her own skin, which we could clearly witness in her speech when she was speaking. However, she speaks a little bit fast and she needs to tone down when she's talking. Also, she stammered a lot when she was giving her final question and answer speech. So that is where she needs to work upon. Lastly, we have Roshali Yadav. Now, Roshali created an impressive profile even before the finale began. Many of the people were actually putting her up in the top 3. But when she was giving her top 10 opening statement, I think she evaded from whatever she was saying. So her direction of speech diverted to somewhere else and she could not create a convincing sort of vibe around her, which is why I think she could not make it to the top 5 finalists. Things I really loved about Miss Diva 2020 finale. I love that they adopted the Miss Universe format in the pageant, which was extremely appreciable. Thereafter, there was no useless Bollywood drama, for which I give 10 on 10 points for Miss Diva pageant. India is one of the early countries to have crowned its delegate for Miss Universe pageant. I think Adline has a lot of time to polish the skills which she already embodied. Adline has a great walk, she has top-notch styling and she never disappoints when she comes on stage. She is easily moldable and she has fierce expressions. At the same time, she has a very graceful demeanor. Her overall appearance is quite exotic, which might be appreciated by many other countries' pageant fans as well. She speaks great and she's working towards a great cause. I think she has time to build a social media momentum right now. She has a lot of time and she's working towards a great advocacy, and this could be done very well when she takes advantage of a social media platform, reaching out to many other people from the pageant world and showing what her advocacy really stands for. Will India earn another consecutive placement at Miss Universe pageant? I certainly think that India has a high chance of getting placement at Miss Universe pageant. Now, will she win the Miss Universe crown? I think it's too early to comment on this because many of the countries have still not crowned their delegates for Miss Universe pageant. So we may not know who all are her competitors when she'll be competing at the Miss Universe pageant. But potential-wise, I think she has the potential to shine out effectively at the Miss Universe pageant. As I said in my previous video, I am completely mesmerized with the classic raw Indian beauty Aavriti embodies. Aavriti has beautiful skin tone, she has natural curly hair, which I really appreciate, and she has a great stage presence as well. She comes across as a highly confident woman. What she needs to work upon is her communication skills. While she was speaking, she stammered a lot in between. But the good thing is that she can be easily transformed, as I mentioned in the case of Adline. The problem arises when we pick rigid women like Urvashi Rautela, who already know many things and are very hard to change or transform. But when we pick girls who are easily transformable, there is a scope of improvement. The same thing I witnessed in the case of Aavriti Chaudhary. So if she polishes her communication skills, I think she has a long way to go at Miss Supranational pageant. She can deliver extremely well. Now it's time to take up your questions, as I took a poll at Instagram asking you to ask me questions which I'll be answering in this particular video. So I have some questions with me. Ritika asked, what is every girl's strength and weakness they can work upon if they come back? I will be stating one quality for each girl which they need to work upon if they ever plan to come back to pageantry. Anisha, be a little bit more natural. Archana, level up your styling. Lavanya, be active on social media, create a wave. Rishali, speak more clearly and lucidly. Arshina, level up your energy. Vaishnavi, polish your walk. Roshni, level up your communication and come back with a bang. Shinchan asked, why were Sachin Kumar's backstage commentary not shown in live telecast? I think at the Miss Universe pageant, when we are watching the pageant, the best thing about the pageant is the backstage commentary, where the backstage commentator goes and asks the contestants how they're actually feeling at that particular moment. So this is what I also missed in the finale of Miss Diva 2020. However, they might be exceeding the limited time and they might be time bound, so certain videos would have been edited during the final telecast. Game of Crowns asked, who should come back in pageantry and in what pageant? I think Rushali Yadav, if she comes back for Femina Miss India, Miss Grand India title would be perfect for her. Grand International is all about photo shoots and how your stage presence reflects when you're walking down the runway. Rushali, with her top-notch styling and her expressions and a beautiful face, can effectively shine at the Miss Grand International and can also become the first Miss Grand International. Next, I have Lavanya Gunasekar with me. I want her to come back for Femina Miss India and win the Miss World India title, for she has an impressive profile and she speaks like a dream. So if she plans to come back, I think Miss World India would be a suitable title for Lavanya. Next, we have Jay, who asks, we know Adline is perfect, but on what segment she must work upon? I think Adline has a lot of time to build a wave in social media. She's working towards a great cause and it is a very unique cause where she plans to empower the female farmers of India. Now, this particular cause has never been talked about at the Miss Universe stage, for which I think she can earn a lot of marks even before she reaches to compete at the Miss Universe pageant. She should use her social media effectively in order to make her advocacy more visible to other pageant fans from other countries as well. Now, Pritam asked me to comment on gown and music. I think the gown was pretty much workable. However, I was completely disappointed with the music. I think it was too slow for any pageant. So any pageant fan or even the contestant who is walking down the runway would not enjoy to walk on such music. So this could be improved. Next, I have Vinny's question, where he asked me to give a detailed view on Vaishnavi. I think Vaishnavi is a quite strong candidate and she needs to polish the skills which she already has. At the age of 18, if she could effectively stand out in the crowd, I think if she polishes and works on her skills, she can be a great competitor in the years to come. She has to improve her stage presence and her walk. And if she improves these skills, I think she will be one to beat for if she comes back for Femina Miss India pageant or even Miss Diva pageant in the coming years. So these were my views on Miss Diva 2020 Grand Finale. Do not forget to subscribe to this channel. Also, do not forget to share what you feel about Miss Diva 2020 Finale in the comment section below. Until then, I will see you soon in the next video.